Hola, hola amigos. How are you? ¿Cómo están? Welcome back to another episode of Español con Señora Baez. What day is it today? ¿Qué día es hoy? Well, I'm recording and today's Thursday, so I'm going to say hoy es, today is 4, the 4th, de febrero de 2021. 4 de febrero de 2021. Hoy es jueves, today is Thursday. Ayer fue miércoles, yesterday was Wednesday. Y mañana será viernes, tomorrow will be Friday. So let's say you're watching this video on Monday, lunes 8, Monday the 8th. So we'll say hoy es, today is lunes 8 de febrero de 2021. Ayer fue domingo y mañana será martes. So, because we are working on dates and when we're reading the weather or talking about the weather, we'll be working on how to say today's temperature is. So, I'm going to play this video to review the bigger numbers and then we will work on expressing the temperature using those bigger numbers. So, it's a review. Remember that in Spanish, after number 20, you combine the tens with the ones. For example, 20 is 20 and 1 is 1. So to say 21, you say 21. Same with 31. 30 is 30, 1 is 1. If you say 31, you combine those by saying 31. I hope this video helps. So we know we are in mes de febrero, we're in the month of February, and that is the month where we have Valentine's Day. So let's practice the months, los meses. Enero, febrero, marzo, abril, mayo, junio, julio, agosto, septiembre, octubre, noviembre, diciembre. En febrero es el día de San Valentín. February is Valentine's Day. Or we can also say el día del amor y la amistad. The day of love and friendship. Let's go over some Valentine's Day vocabulary. Amor, love. Amor, love. Corazón, heart. Corazón, heart. Friendship is amistad. Amistad. Let's practice saying.
is Happy Valentine's,
Happy Valentine's Day.
In Spanish, that is Feliz Día de San Valentín. This is a five-word phrase. Feliz Día de San Valentín, meaning Happy Valentine's Day. Again, the phrase is Feliz Día de San Valentín, Happy Valentine's Day. If you want to learn more Spanish, make sure to subscribe to
Let's say that together one more time. Feliz.
Today's phrase is Happy.
Feliz Día de San Valentín. So we are going to watch a video where her name is Pamela, and she's going to show us how to make a quick Valentine's Day card. I want you to pay attention to the vocabulary that comes up on the video and the ending, like what she writes on the card.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Mi nombre es Pamela y estoy muy contenta de estar otro video más contigo. Tengo muchos amigos y pronto va a ser Día de San Valentín o bien Día del Amor y la Amistad. Se celebra el 14 de febrero y quiero regalarles algo, pero no sé qué. Se me ocurre regalar dulces, fotos, tarjetas. Estaba haciendo una tarjeta, pero no sé qué hacer. Ya sé. Voy a hacer corazones de diferentes tamaños. Voy a hacer un corazón grande, color rojo. Tengo ahora tres corazones. Un corazón rojo grande, un corazón pequeño rosa y un corazón mediano morado. Ahora voy a necesitar pegamento para pegarlos y que se vea bonita nuestra tarjeta para Ana. Ahora voy a escribirle algo bonito a mi amiga Ana. Feliz Día de San Valentín. Te quiero mucho. Y le voy a poner besos. Listo, ya tengo mi primera tarjeta para mi amiga Ana. Qué linda, ¿no? Y dime, ¿cómo se llama tu mejor amigo? No olvides suscribirte, darle like y picarle a la campanita para que no te pierdas ninguno de nuestros videos. Adiós.
Okay, so let's go over some of the keywords that she said in the video. She talked about the date of Valentine's Day, which is 14 de febrero. Let's say that together. 14 de febrero. That means February 14th. She was trying to figure out what to regalar. Regalar is gift. What to gift her friends. She couldn't figure out if she could do dulces, candy, photos, pictures, or tarjetas, cards. So she decided to make a card. Tarjeta. That means card. So she cut out some corazones. What are corazones? Hearts. She cut out uno rosado, rojo, y morado. Pink, red, and purple. Then, she used pegamento, glue, to glue them on the white paper. And she wrote something nice, algo bonito, a su amiga Ana. She wrote, Feliz Día de San Valentín. Happy Valentine's Day. She said, te quiero mucho.
Te quiero mucho.
That means I love you very much. And at the end, she wrote besos. That's like writing XO. It means kisses, but you know people write that at the end of letters. And so this is something you can make at home and do for your parents or for your friends. ¿Cómo se llama tu mejor amigo? What is your best friend's name? ¿Cómo se llama tu mejor amigo? Comment below the video if you like to tell me who's your best friend.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Mi nombre es Pamela y estoy muy...
Okay, let's go to the next slide. We're going to change topics and talk about el clima. What is el clima? El clima is the weather. We're going to talk about ¿qué tiempo hace hoy? What's the weather today? Okay, so the first thing we're going to review is the vocabulary that we've been learning for the past few weeks. It's on the right side. Let's go over these words together. Repeat after me. Soleado, soleado, sunny. Nublado, nublado, cloudy. Frío, frío, cold. Cálido, cálido, warm. Fresco, fresco, cool. Mal tiempo, bad weather. Buen tiempo, good weather. Now let's look at the forecast. So we have today, which is Thursday. I'm recording on Thursday. It shows la temperatura, the temperature, es de 43 grados. The temperature is 43 degrees. Grados is degrees. So let's go to Saturday. ¿Qué tiempo hace el sábado? What's the weather on Saturday? El sábado, la temperatura es de 53 grados. Temperature will be up to 53 degrees. Va a estar un poco nublado. It will be partly cloudy. Let's go to Monday. ¿Qué tiempo hace hoy? Lunes. Lunes, la temperatura es de 61 grados. 61 degrees. Y está fresco. It will be cool. El martes, on Tuesday, va a estar nublado. It will be cloudy. Y el jueves, and next Thursday, it looks like va a haber mal tiempo. The weather will be bad on Thursday because it looks like it's a wintry mix. So let's look at examples of bad weather. Huracán, hurricane. Tormenta de nieve, snowstorm. Tornado, tornado. Inundación, flood, inundación. Now we're going to read about these in sentences. Let's see here. Ejemplos de mal tiempo en oraciones. Examples of bad weather in within sentences. Let's start with the first one at the top. El tornado trae vientos de 100 millas por hora. El tornado trae vientos de 100 millas por hora. The tornado brings winds of 100 miles per hour. El huracán trae mucha lluvia. El huracán trae mucha lluvia. The hurricane brings a lot of rain. La inundación cubrió todo de agua. La inundación cubrió todo de agua. The flood covered everything in water. So now we are going to review the seasons. Conecta el perro con la estación. We have four perros, and we're going to connect it with the appropriate season. So we have primavera, verano, otoño, invierno. Let's start with otoño. Otoño sounds like autumn or fall. That's otoño. Invierno. Invierno is winter. Verano, summer. Primavera, spring. Let's review them one more time. Invierno, winter. Otoño, fall. Verano, summer. And primavera is spring. Let's review la ropa, clothes, la ropa. Let's start with going over the words in this graphic. Gorra, cap. Sombrero, hat. Repeat after me. Pantalones, largos, long pants, pantalones cortos, short pants, falda, skirt, vestido, dress, pijamas, pajamas, camisa, shirt, blusa, blouse, camiseta, t-shirt, chaqueta, jacket, zapatos, tenis, tennis shoes, botas, boots, sandalia, sandal, zapatos, shoes, repeat after me, tacones, heels, pantuflas, house slippers, aretes, earrings, bolso, purse, collar, necklace, lentes, glasses, bufanda, scarf, medias o calcetines, socks, cinturón, belt, abrigo, also like a jacket, but this one's like warmer. An abrigo is warmer. So if we were going swimming, whoops, what is something we could need for swimming? We probably need shorts. So we're going to say, necesitamos, we need pantalones cortos, shorts. Going to an important meeting. Going to an important meeting, I'll say dress shoes. Necesitamos, we need zapatos, shoes. Like dressier shoes. Going to the beach. Going to the beach, I'm going to take a gorra. Necesito, I need una gorra. Cutting the grass. Well, if you've ever cut the grass, you know you need long pants. Pantalones largos. Walking at the park during winter. Breezy. We need un abrigo, a coat. Attending a sleepover. We're going to need pijamas. Attending a church service, we're going to need camisa, a dress shirt. Walking your dog during fall, we're going to need a chaqueta, a jacket. So let's review. For the beach, we said we'll need a gorra, which is a cap, to keep our face protected from el sol. To go to an important meeting, we said we'll need dress shoes, zapatos, to go to cut the grass, long pants so that your legs don't get hurt, pantalones largos, to go swimming, pantalones cortos, walking at the park during winter, abrigo, a coat, walking your dog during fall, chaqueta, a jacket, attending a church service, camisa, dress shirt, and for a sleepover, pijamas. Pijamas are pajamas. Muy bien, amigos. So with the weather, or related to weather, I want you all to tell me if the weather's bueno or malo. So I'll put the picture up. You tell me, ¿hace buen tiempo o hace mal tiempo? So in this picture, ¿hace buen tiempo o hace mal tiempo? Hace buen tiempo. The weather's nice. What about this one? ¿Hace buen tiempo o hace mal tiempo? Hace mal tiempo. The weather's bad. ¿Hace buen tiempo o hace mal tiempo? Hace mal tiempo. Un tornado se está formando. ¿Hace buen tiempo o hace mal tiempo? Hace buen tiempo. ¿Hace buen tiempo o hace mal tiempo? Hace buen tiempo. Let's talk about this map and talk about la temperatura. So at the top, we have the sentence, la temperatura is the temperature is So we're going to look at the cities on the right and we'll say the whole phrase with the number of the temperature. So let's start with número uno. It says Miami or Miami. In Miami, la temperatura es de 84 grados. In Miami, la temperatura es de 84 grados. In Miami, the temperature is 84 degrees. Let's go to número dos. Los Ángeles. En Los Ángeles, la temperatura es de 70 grados. En Los Ángeles, la temperatura es de 70 grados. Minneapolis. En Minneapolis, la temperatura es de 46 grados. En Minneapolis, la temperatura es de 46 grados. Atlanta. En Atlanta, la temperatura es de 73 grados. En Atlanta, la temperatura es de 73 grados. Número 5. Salt Lake City. En Salt Lake City, la temperatura es de 46 grados. Seattle. En Seattle, la temperatura es de 54 grados. Kansas City. En Kansas City, la temperatura es de 63 grados. Chicago. En Chicago, la temperatura es de 59 grados. ¿En qué ciudades hace sol? ¿En qué, in which, ciudades, cities, hace sol? We have one, we have two. ¿En Caribou hace sol? Be patient with me, you guys know this is hard to write with. ¿En Caribou hace sol? Where else? En Jacksonville hace sol. En Caribou y en Jacksonville hace sol. Muy bien. ¿En qué ciudades está nublado? Está nublado en Minneapolis y está nublado en Dallas. En Minneapolis y en Dallas está nublado. Las mascotas, pets. So we're going to start a new topic today and we'll continue this for the next month or so. It's los animales, animals. We'll start with pets.
Tío Spenis, aprender español.
¡Hola, amigos! ¿Qué tal? Me encantan los animales. Tengo un montón de mascotas en casa. Vamos a conocerlas. Este es el perro. Vengo de pasearlo. El gato, que siempre me espera en la ventana. Los peces en su pecera. Y la tortuga, que camina muy lenta. Tengo varios pájaros. Este más pequeño es el canario. Y al loro le gusta repetir todo lo que digo. ¡Hola, amigos! ¿Qué tal? ¡Hola, amigos! ¿Qué tal? El hámster que corre en la rueda. Y el conejo que va saltando por toda la casa. Estas son las mascotas. Vamos a repasarlas. Perro, gato, peces, tortuga, canario, loro, hámster, conejo. Pues nada, amigos, a cuidar mucho a los animales. Un saludo y hasta la próxima.
So they showed us their pets. They showed us what they do around their house. And they said a cuidar de los animales at the end. which means take care of your pets. Okay, so now we're going to apply some of that vocabulario, some of that vocabulary from that video. And we're going to connect la foto con la palabra, the word with the picture. So we have a dog, a mouse, a cat, and a fish. So we'll start with the top. Pez. It's not dog. It is fish. Gato. Cat. Perro. Dog. And ratón. Mouse. El perro es pequeño. The dog is small. El pez es colorido. The fish is colorful. El gato es muy bonito. The cat is very pretty. Those are some things we can say about these animales. And remember, most body parts are the same, like orejas are ears. But the only thing is legs are patas. Patas, not piernas. So, amigos, we are at the end of the lesson. Let's go over ¿qué aprendiste hoy? What did you learn today? Repasamos, we reviewed. Las estaciones, los días y los meses. The seasons, the days and the months. La fecha, the date. We reviewed, repasamos, la ropa, vocabulario, clothes. Then aprendimos, we learned about el día de San Valentín, which is Valentine's Day. And we started learning about los animales. We learned about las mascotas, pets. Oh, we also reviewed el clima, weather, y la temperatura, the temperature, and how to say the temperature, which is la temperatura es de. ¿Cómo está el clima hoy? That means how's the weather today? After I write my notes, we will go over these together. And about pets, we learn perro is dog, gato, cat, pez, fish, ratón, mouse. And we will learn how to use these in sentences next week. So let's go over all this. Repasamos, reviewed las estaciones, seasons, los días y los meses. La fecha, the date, the days and the months. La ropa, vocabulario, vocabulary about clothing. El clima, ¿cómo está el clima hoy? How is the weather today? La temperatura, when we're saying what temperature it is, we'll say la temperatura es de, and then we put the number here. Aprendimos el día de San Valentín, Valentine's Day, los animales, animals, las mascotas, pets, and we have perro, gato, pez, ratón. I hope you enjoyed today's episode of Español con Señora Báez. I hope you have a great rest of your week. Adiós.